Coming in at number 77 on our top 100 movies of all time list is David Cronenberg's The Fly, starring Jeff Goldblum and Gina Davis, who had an incredible love story on screen in this movie, which is a layer that I really wasn't expecting out of this creature feature.
You didn't expect to be turned on?
Well, I just thought that they were great together. I think they became a really cool
chemistry.
Yeah, they really did.
Yeah, you know,
they?
This is my first introduction to David Cronenberg, the great Canadian director.
Not afraid of the gore. Not afraid of the squishy, gooey, disgusting stuff.
A little personal story here. I would go on to graduate high school in 1987, and this movie came out in 1986, and this was a time of personal transformation for me. My body itself was transforming.
Okay.
I was becoming the sex stallion that I am today.
Did you need a telepod, or
no,
was it just happening?
I just found this movie particularly endearing because I'm looking at this guy who is a scientist. He's a big nerd, and he lives in his huge loft. Yeah. Only these scientists
only
lofts.
In movies.
Only in movies can you live in these science lofts. I think most scientists live in basements. But he has these two telepods, and he's trying to transport organic material from one telepod to the other. Goes horribly wrong with a monkey.
Well,
and then that monkey sort of turns into a...
Oh, my God.
Terrible, right?
Yeah.
Remember that?
I just threw up in my mouth a little bit.
And then he gets in there. Only a fly flies into the other side.
Bad day.
And he comes out, and he's half DNA of a man and half DNA of a fly. And at first, he seems okay.
Yeah.
Now you tell me. Am I different somehow?
But then he just starts falling apart, and his body starts going out of control. But he also starts acquiring these superpowers at the same time.
Yeah, it's the inverse of the Spider-Man origin story, only that he quickly metamorphosizes into this just disgusting, gelatinous, gross, giant fly creature.
Who knew that flies wanted to have so much sex? Because he tries to have all the sex he can with Gina Davis, and I don't blame him there one bit.
Well, I mean, he just has all of these heightened senses and heightened abilities. He's climbing up on walls. And Goldblum, with his idiosyncrasies and his very special brand of quirk,
like
is just
him.
Perfect
yeah,
in this role.
Like him.
It made it as me and the fly. We hadn't even been properly introduced.
This is a star-making performance. You can see the guy just reveling in all of this unbelievably cool material. The effects were incredible. I mean, it hasn't been beaten in terms of transforming into a monster type thing. This was some really cool stuff.
It's a movie that I forget about for some reason, and I don't know why I do, because it is so terrific and so captivating, and once you start watching it, it just kind of washes over you, and suddenly it's over, and you're like, well, wait a second, something profound just happened.
I know, and Cronenberg has made fantastic movies, lots of really cool things that make you stop and think beyond their subject matter, beyond the grotesqueries that you see on screen. But I think The Fly was maybe his most measured, his most accomplished, his most accessible piece of work. I don't know if it's his best movie per se, but it's the most enjoyable movie that I think he has made.
I'm becoming Brundle Fly. Don't you think that's worth a Nobel Prize or two?
But he's also smart enough to make a movie that is a monster movie with plenty of heart and humanity. These characters are real people, and I don't think any of it would work unless you felt the horror and self-disgust and sense of empowerment, that combination of those three things that feels all too human, I think, to all of us, especially if you're, you know, an 18-year-old kid trying to figure out the rest of your life. So this movie really spoke to me, and it always will speak to me. David Cronenberg and The Fly, congratulations, you're number 77 in our list of the 100 greatest films of all time.
We salute you, Jeff Goldblum.
Go Canada.